Today, they're in Stafford to meet an artist whose house is in need of attention.
Some little doggies here, I think.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Wenda lives in a 9-bedroomed house, but in spite of that, each of the rooms is now full to the brim, and the hoard is spilling over into every part of the house.
My God. Oh, my life, Wenda, what?
Wow.
What?
That's a lot of stuff.
Do you like snakes?
Is that alive?
Not in formaldehyde, no. I usually pickled them in vodka after that because I couldn't get formaldehyde anymore.
I'm petrified of snakes.
He'll be able to see out of his jar when we've cleaned it.
Oh, my God.
This is my bedroom. Oh, some people probably wouldn't like to have lots of things around them, but for me, I know they're there, so it makes me feel secure.
The problem has got so bad that she can no longer sleep in her own bedroom.
I'm going to now try and get round the door. So when was the last time you were actually slept in this room, Wenda?
Just before Christmas.
Just before Christmas, but you'd like to get back in this room.
Yes.
Let's do this.
This is the kitchen.
Okay.
I need organisation. You can organise my cupboard, you can organise whatever, okay. As long as I know when I come back in there...
Where everything is.
Everything is.
Okay.
I'll be fine.
OK.
Upstairs, Wenda used to have a room for her painting. But since the hoarding took hold, there just isn't the space.
This is supposed to be my art come hobby room.
My goodness. Look at these pictures.
There's a lot in here.
Yes.
Isn't
that? Art to me is a way of escaping probably from reality. It just makes me feel happy.
I've never seen so much stuff in one room. One door I've just tried to open and we can't even get in. It's a hoarding to a whole bigger level than I've ever seen.
I'm not embarrassed. I'm ashamed of the way that place has become. Because I just can't deal with it. It's just overwhelming.
No way would she be able to do this on her own. No way.
Rubber gloves at the ready and crack on now. Get it done.
Yvonne and Angela plan to reclaim the bedroom for Wenda.
Look at this.
Get the kitchen into a usable state.
That's grim.
Oh. And clear her art room so she can paint again.
This looks important.
Yeah.
But they've been asked not to throw anything away without checking with Wenda first.
Yeah, that's part of my collection.
You want to keep them, yeah?
Yeah.
And every item has a memory attached to it.
Oh, there's a glass that my mother brought back from Belgium at the end of the war. I really need to keep that because it's part of my mother's life as well as mine. I grew up with it.
We have been in homes where people hoard and they're really organised. Rooms are stacked, books in one corner, paperwork in a next.
I tell you what, she knows what's in these rooms.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you throw anything that she doesn't want throwing, she'll know.
Yeah, yeah.
Photos of paintings. These are some of the paintings I've done. So maybe I should keep some of them. I'll see what I can let go of without feeling sick.
The lady knows exactly what is in this room.
Somehow I don't think we're going to be filling this skip, because I think everything in there is going to be staying in there.
Despite Wenda's initial reluctance, they've managed to fill the skip with 3 tons of rubbish.
Oh, my God!
And at last they can start on the clean.
What is this?
That's what smells in here.
I know what that is. The dog's been weeing up that bin.
That's going on while I clear it. Because there's actually dog feces here as well. We just need to kill the smell while we're working in here.
That's gone.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
With the kitchen under control, they can turn their attention to the upstairs bedroom and art room.
What should we do with this?
Get lost.
Oh, my God. It's black wee.
Don't.
Right. Oh, my God, it stinks.
Put the lid up.
Ha ha ha!
I've never been sick on the job.
I've definitely urged a few times. Luckily, never been sick yet, which is a bonus, but yeah, definitely urged a few times over a couple of things.
Pub toilets in the morning, I actually went in, cleaned the toilet, was sick, and then cleaned the toilet again.
And so you should.
Oh, it was the worst hangover ever, and I had to go to work.
3 days ago, Wenda's house was choking under years of cluttered possessions and artwork. Now she gets to see the place clean for the first time in years.
Dare I come in?
You can.
Come on in, lovely lady.
Oh, my God. I haven't seen the tops for how long. You have no idea what that means to me.
Oh,
to have it all
organized
that, so I can deal with things.
Yes.
Oh. Oh, it's unbelievable. I never thought it would look like a bedroom again.
Before, Wenda's art room was nothing more than a dumping ground.
Oh, I can't believe it.
Now it can be used for painting once more.
Incredible. I just can't tell you.
No. Come here. Give us a hug. Come here.
No idea. I feel quite liberated and I have space to do what I want to do. It's an absolute joy. No one has any idea what that means to someone that wants to paint. I mean, it's just wonderful. You've made my day.
Oh, yeah, you will.
Bless you. Take care, sweetheart.
Bye-bye, darling.
Bye-bye.
Thanks for everything.
You're welcome.
To see her face, look at me, was just overwhelming. It really, really was. You forget all the hard work and the frustration yesterday. You forget that.